Hello everyone, it's Educatify here, back with a brand new video. Today we are going to learn about computer networking architecture, and this is the fourth video on networking technology. If you have not watched the first, second and third video, make sure to watch it. The link is on the description below. So without wasting much time, let's start today's content. We are back here today with computer network architecture, and we are covering the networking technology series. So let's begin about computer network architecture. So let's see some overview of computer network architecture. Network architecture defines how the computer communicates and interacts with each other on the network. It is combined form of topologies and data transmission mode between the different computers in the network. So there are basically three types of network architecture. The first one is peer-to-peer network, client-server network, and centralized computing network. So we will be discussing about all of those. So let's start with peer-to-peer network architecture. In this type of network, all nodes on the network have an equal relationship with each other. It is also called work group. It can say data, hardware and software with each other. It is suitable for small areas such as small offices, small rooms, buildings, etc. And it uses many operating systems such as Windows 2000, Windows 8, Macintosh operating system, etc. have built-in features to support peer-to-peer network. As you can see in the diagram as well, peer is actually a self-sufficient computer. So here in this computer can share data to this computer can share data to this computer, and actually a peer access both client and server here. Everyone can share their data to each other. That's what peer-to-peer network is. And even it is a network model in which the resource sharing and processing and communication control are completely decentralized. It is not centralized upon particular servers or host. It is totally decentralized. So now let's see some of the advantages of using peer-to-peer network architecture. Actually, in peer-to-peer network architecture, all resources can be shared in this network by each and every nodes or the computers that are being used. So system administrator is not required due to that reason, and each user can control their shared resources. And the failure of one computer does not affect the functioning of other peers, and it is actually easy and inexpensive to use. So that were some of the advantages of peer-to-peer network. Now let's see some of the disadvantages of peer-to-peer network, using peer-to-peer network. Actually, it is difficult for administration and control, as resources are decentralized in this network. So security is very low in this system, and data recovery or backup is very difficult in this situation. So there are three major disadvantages. First is difficult for administration and control of resources, as it is decentralized. And security is very low in the system, and data recovery or backup is very difficult. So these were some of the disadvantages of peer-to-peer network. Now we are heading towards client-server network. We have already learned about client and server many times in this whole series, but now again let's revise it. A network model where one or more powerful computers or servers, we have already discussed that they are very powerful and they share the resources, provide the different network services. We have also discussed about network services, file services, print services, message services, application services, database services and others, and all other users of computer network, means client, who accesses those services from servers to perform users task is known as client server network. In such networks, there exists a central controller called server. A server is a specialized computer that controls the network resources and provides services to the other computers in the network, including other servers or other clients. Novell NetWare, Windows NT, Linux, etc. are the common examples of an operating system of client server network. In this diagram also you can see here, there is a specialized server who is providing internet access to its client. So that's how a client server network architecture is used, and it is very common network architecture used in the world right now. So let's see about advantages of using client server network architecture. Actually, centralized backup is possible in client server computer network. Centralized backup and the use of dedicated server also increases the speed of sharing resources, and security is better in network as all the shared resources are centrally administered. So these were some of the advantages of client server network. Now let's discuss about some of the drawbacks or disadvantages of client server network. Actually, it requires specialized servers with large memory. This leads to an increase in the price and cost. The cost of network operating system that manages the various clients is also high. So it requires a network administrator. So we have to develop a network administrator to use this client server network. The next we have to see about is the centralized computing. Centralized computing. In this network, the main computer is known as the host or server computer. In this network, there will be a host or server computer. Okay. There will be a host or server computer, and workstation is just used for input or output operation, which has no processing capabilities and are connected to server or host computer. Linux or Unix operating system are used in centralized network. So actually, what centralized computing is? It is a network model in which a host computer is connected to other computer or terminals, and it provides data or computing services via a network. So the host computer is the core of the centralized computing model. A network host may offer information resources, services, and application to the users or other nodes on the network. So centralized computing network provides high performance and centralized management, but it also is very much expensive to implement. Centralized computing network is also called host-based network. This is a simple demonstration of centralized computing. So now let's see some of the advantages of centralized computing. So actually it says cost of installation of network system. It says the cost of installation of network system, but it is actually quite expensive as well to develop it. Okay, but to develop the host computer and terminals, it is quite difficult, but it saves the cost of installation of network system. So it secures all data and information on host computer which work on IPOS, means input process output system. So it secures the data and information on host computers which only works on IPOS and which is input process output system. So host computer gives facilities like disk storage and software to workstation, which is quite advantageous. So these were some of the advantages of centralized computing. Now let's see some of the disadvantages or drawbacks of centralized computing. Actually, the malfunctioning of host computer affects other workstation as well, and created a situation where the network may fail. So it takes a long time for data processing, and it is difficult to add more workstation in centralized computing. So these were some of the disadvantages of centralized computing. So guys, thank you for watching today's video. If you like this content, don't forget to hit the like button, comment down your feedbacks, and share these videos and help people educate. And if you like this content, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Have a good day. Thank you.